Everybody, it's me, Dishes, Dishes. Okay, so you saw me when I made the chili and I peeled it. So what I've done now is, here's the chili, and I try to take as many seeds out as I possibly can. So I'm only making three because it's just me and Michael. So what I did is I laid them on some paper towels so that I could let the moisture come out of them before I fill them with the cheese. I usually just buy 30 prepackaged. And I usually like to get really good cheese. And you can use any kind of cheese you like. So, see, I opened it. Take one out. A bunch come out. Okay, there's three. One. Cut. But you know, you don't have to cut. Cool. Okay. Then, what I'm going to do is you slide it in between the middle of the chili. See how I'm sliding it in? So I'm going to do two more and put them in the refrigerator and let them sit for a little bit. And then I'll do my batter. I'll show you how I'm going to do my batter, but I'll be right back. But this is the first part of my chile relleno. Chile relleno. Okay, guys. Be right back. Bye. Dishes. Subscribe. Okay, guys, let's do the batter for the chile relleno. Okay, so I have two eggs, garlic, salt, and first a little bit of starch. And I'll show you what I do with the starch. So what I'm going to do is I only want the whites in here, and I'm going to put the yellow oaks in there. So I'm going to break these open. You can have like one of those fancy things that people have like to separate the, ooh, darn it. Supposed to go in here. Well, it's okay. Come on, da-da. Come on, Iggy. Let's bring that up. Pour this in there. Okay. See, sometimes you do make mistakes, but no biggie. Okay, so the whites go in there. Come on, Mike. White. There, that was a good plop out. Okay, cool. The rest of my hands. Salmonella. Okay, pinch your hands. Okay, so I'm gonna beat this up. I use the beaters and whisk it till it's really good. Let me get these in. Hold on. So I'm gonna make a meringue. Like, okay, and so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get this going, and then I'm just gonna turn this on and it like that for a little bit, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, so let's get this started, be back and show you what I do with the rest of the stuff. Okay, dishes, subscribe. Okay, guys, someone's got on there. Okay, so see it, you can tell when it's ready because it's really like really fluffy. See, okay, let's put that to the side. So then what we're gonna do is the yellows, we're gonna season them. So we're going to fold these into the whites. Some garlic. You can put as much as you want. It's no big deal. Okay, this is the starch. I'm going to put a little bit of starch in here so it firms this up a little bit. The yellows. This can put a little bit. Then all I'm going to do is whisk this, and I'm going to whisk it on low. So be careful because it can throw up, you know, splash out. So I'm going to do this. Okay, see how it looks? See, it got thicker. The starch gets it to be a little bit thicker instead of it being like runny. Have you ever had a scrambled eggs of this? Oh, so good. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm a little at a time. Okay, watch. Just a little at a time. A little bit there. Go. I'm going to fold it in. See? Folding it. Put as much as you like in them. Fold it in. Fold it in. This is going to be our batter for our chili rellenos. Okay. Fold some around. Okay, fold it in. looking really good. Some people like to use flour, but I don't. See, holding it in, see? How pretty that looks. Put it all in. You can put as much as you like. You don't have to use it all, but okay. There we go. Almost done. Pull it in. See? See how that looks? That's my batter for my chili rellenos. Okay, so what I'm going to do is clean up my little mess and move over to the stove. I'm going to use lard. Remember, I'm the lard queen. Yahoo! I like lard. So I will move everything over to the other side of the counter and we'll start up again. Okay, guys, be right back. Dishes, dishes. Chili rellenos. Yum, yum, yum. Scrumshy dumshy. I'm going to put a, I just want a little bit of oil because I don't want it, I don't want the rellenos to get drenched in oil. You know what I mean? Sometimes some things take just a little bit of oil, not a whole bunch of oil. It can cause more, I mean, it just depends on what you're trying to cook. Come on. Let's start to warm up. So it's going to start warming up. So, here is my batter. Put these over here. I guess I can right over here. Sometimes it's easier to sometimes use forks to turn stuff. And I have little tongies. Put these there for right now. Okay. Mike made some green chili. Next time I'll have him do the green chili because he is his. I gotta say, there's some things that some people are so much better than other people when they cook. You know, we're not all pros at everything. If we were, oh my god, the world would be awful. Okay, that's warming up. So you gotta be really careful when you're making these because you don't want the egg batter to burn and you don't want your cheese to all melt out. So it's getting cold though. Okay, let's do another one. Stick it in there. Flip it around. Can you see? You just gotta make sure you don't want it to burn. That's the key thing, is you don't want it to burn. So you see how it's cooking? Flip it. And see what right there it came off a little bit. So what I'm gonna do is get a little bit of batter. Just a little bit. See what it looks like? Pretty good. And then some people like to use flour, I don't. So just cooking it, you just gotta be careful, you don't burn it. I don't. There it is. Pretty much it. And then I'll stick it in the oven and let it melt the cheese a little bit more. I'm done with that one. It's out. Okay, that's it. And I'll be back to show you what else I'm going to do.
I got
here is your chili smothered with some green chili and beans. And we're going to have a tortilla with it too. So here it is. Yum, yum. Scrumptious, scrumptious. Does it look good? Does it look good? Yum, yum, yum. And you can make it any which way you like. I mean, this is like without any flour in it, it's egg. And you could actually use the batter that I just did and put it in flour if you want it more mossy. So this is our chili relleno. We're going to eat now. Bye, guys. Yum, yum. Hey guys, hi. Okay, let's try this. This is the chili relleno. Really good. Beans. This is really good. This is really good. Okay, guys. Try the chili relleno, it's delicious. And I showed you how to make the beans and the pressure cooker.
Really good. And ham hocks. Mm. Tortilla. Mm. Okay, try this recipe. I know you'll like it. Dishes, dishes. Bye. Subscribe, remember? And there's all different kinds of recipes out there for chili relleno, just how you like it made. So you can make it whichever way you like, but try this dish. Easy to make. Bye, guys.